Hi, my name is Lee Lazarow, and I'm the director of the Planning Analytics team here at Revelwood. Today, I'm going to show you some approaches you can use with the new set editor. So I'm going to start with an exploration. And in this particular case, maybe I want to change one of my dropdowns. For my departments, right now I'm looking at my total departments and I'm looking at the first level below. But maybe I want my end users to see sales and marketing and the first level below and only sales and marketing. There are three different ways that I can open the set editor to change it. Approach number one to change it, I can double click. By double clicking on the dimension is going to open up the set editor. Option number two, I can click on the three dots over to the right and I have the option to open the set editor. And approach number three, if I have it enabled to turn on the set editor, when I click on the dropdown, I see the elements that are currently in the set, but I have the ability to go into set editor. The reason I say if it's enabled is when you're creating your exploration, you have the opportunity to set up your properties to determine, do I want set editor on or do I not want it on? Since it's on right now, I'm going to choose it. I'm going to click on set editor and it's going to bring me to the pause set editor. So the way that we start is we look at the various available members. And the available members are going to give me the ability to give us some kind of a global starting point. The three global starting points are called all routes, all members, all leaves. All routes. What route is going to define is it's going to define our top of the house component. And the reason I say top of the house is if this is a consolidation point, it's the equivalent of clicking on the all button in the legacy tool, putting everything into a hierarchy order and shrinking it up. When I shrink it up, the top of the house consolidation elements are what we would see as a route. And any base level elements that currently don't roll into some kind of a hierarchy are also what we see. We also have the ability to say all members. Previously I said all routes is clicking on all the elements, doing some kind of an expansion and then shrinking it up. If I stuck with that expansion, that's the equivalent of all members. It's going to give me my elements, it's going to give me my children, it's going to work its way all the way down the hierarchy structure. And within that hierarchy structure, I have consolidations and I have base level elements. Those base level elements are what we call our all leaves. If I were to select the option for all leaves, it's going to give me all of the base level elements. And those are my starting points. So what if I wanted to start with all of the routes? I'm going to click on all routes. And then maybe I want to see some of the pieces within the consolidation. I could click on the expansion ability where I could click on a plus, I can shrink it back up again, I can go down and I can look at it one piece at a time, but I also have the ability to show what would appear. If I right click on this, there's an option that says show, and I can drill down. I can drill down to the children, I can drill down to the leaves, I can drill all the way down to descendants. But the great thing about show is if I were at a level where I'm not at top of the house, I have the ability to drill back up. I can look at my ancestors and parents. For this particular example, I'm just going to show the children. It's going to take total departments. It's going to show me the children. That brings me to the one piece. I can now navigate by digging deeper. I'm going to go into sales and marketing. I'm going to keep it by clicking on this check. And now I have the ability to expand that. Once I've come up with the items that I want to be in my available members, I can click on them one at a time to keep them, to copy them, or in conjunction with the shift key, I can highlight a series of the components. When I highlight a series of components, I now have a new ribbon, and within that ribbon, I can click on copy, I can use that as my replacement, and that gives me the ability to update my set. As soon as I click on apply, these selected items now appear in the drop-down list. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it and I hope you learned something new. Please visit our website at revelwood.com to learn how we can help you discover more about Planning Analytics.